Scott Walker, I am still stuck on Scott Walker. This guy, I really believe, is the reincarnation. I mean, not literally the reincarnation. He was born before Nixon died, but of Richard Nixon. I mean, you know, back when he was in college, the local newspaper endorsed his opponent. His campaigners went around and stole all the newspapers. And then he left college. I mean, he has been involved in political scandal after political scandal. He tried to do away with the sunshine laws in Wisconsin just last week so that people couldn't find out what he's been up to over the last couple of years. I'm convinced that the Koch brothers are going to make sure he's the candidate, and he's been talking about Marco Rubio as his running mate. What are your thoughts on that, on him and on that ticket?
Well, I think it's a disaster, if you want to know the truth. He has a better shot than Rubio. Rubio has the potential to bring him down the same way Sarah Palin brought McCain down. The interesting thing about Scott Walker is, as loony as this guy is once you start digging in, when you watch him, he how does he do on stage? He does pretty well. Think about this, Tom. He was able to fend off an election, all-out approach, all-out war on him right there in his home state when the people were so angry that it was just almost a groundswell, a revolution kind of outrage about this guy. He was able to overcome that because he does have a knack for taking an issue and making it and selling it. It may be a completely crazy issue, like the issue we're talking about with Rubio. He does have the ability to take that issue and make it sound like common sense to many voters.
Yeah, that's astonishing. Not to mention the fact that he may well end up with $800 million behind him just from the Koch brothers and their buddies. Yes. Mike Papantonio, it's always great to see you, my friend. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom.